Hey everyone, how are you? It's me, Jill McKay, coming to you from Fort Collins, Colorado. And I am happy to be here today in a good mood. Hello, Nancy, Cecilia, Leona, and Bess. Yes, please say hi so I know you're here. It makes me feel a lot better knowing I'm talking to you than just myself. Because that would just be silly. Oh, it's been a long week, but a good one. Lots of work. So, thanks to everybody who did the JBB summer camp. That was fun. Got that done. And thank you. You'll be happy to know that right now, as we speak, Donna is putting the labels on to the bead boxes. And there was some confusion with the little video I made showing what's in the bead boxes. And I said something about we were paying for shipping after, and I meant after the priority shipping that you're supposed to choose, because this bead box is the heaviest one yet. It's, I think it's just around a pound and a half. So I thought that it's very possible, because in different places of the country or the world, it's more than not. Anyways, it's all relative to where you live, and I was just saying that we are going to cover the cost of whatever is above the priority shipping charge that you guys paid. So, anyways, some people got, one person got really mad and said I was trying to scam them, and I was like, well, I guess you don't know me very well, because that's just not something I would do. Nope. So customers like that, I don't really need. So if it's you that I'm talking to, I'm good with you not coming back, because my customers are kind and nice and patient. Hey, Linda. Hey, Stephanie. Hey, Betty. Hey, Sharon. Hey, Lauren. Wow. This is awesome. So today, I thought we'd do something a little different. Before I start, it's one of the things. So the Periwinkle Lotus Bracelet Kit is also going out tomorrow. So both the bead boxes and the Periwinkle Bracelet Kit are all shipping tomorrow. So if you have ordered, you will have goodies on their way to you. And we're beating our timeline quite significantly. As I said, the bead boxes wouldn't go out until the first 2 weeks of September. So yay! Better to be early than late. Alright. So let me switch over to my hands. And this is what I, there's one version of what, we're going to make a different version, and then I'll tell you how to make this one too. But this is 1 millimeter metallic pearl leather cord round, and that's on the website. I also have 2 millimeter. I didn't get time. I also have a 0.5 millimeter. But I thought, you know, most people use the 2 or even the 3. I just thought it looked a lot more feminine to use the 1 millimeter, and it's strong enough to pull. So let's start. What I have done is I have cut 2 pieces about 4 feet long. I just take my arm and go from the tip of my finger to my shoulder. I did that 3 times, but then I thought, oh, well, my arms are longer than other people. So then I measured it, and it was about 4 feet, maybe a little under. So I'm getting it 2 needles out. And I'm using a size 10 long. And we're going to be using 2 needles the whole time today. So one of the tricks we've learned is to just flatten the end out just a little. You don't have to, don't squeeze terribly hard, but that really, and then wet it and bring, this is fire line or wildfire, whichever you use. And then, oops, missed. That beige is hard to see between my fingertips. There's one. One threaded. Here's our second one. Also 4 feet long. Another way to do it is just drag it through your teeth. That's what I just did. Pliers, teeth, same principle. So I hope you're all doing well. I hope your week went well. Okay, there's our second one. Alright, so now I'm going to cut. Where did my leather cord go? I just hate it here. I was taking pictures of it and putting it online. Hold on, one moment, please. Goodness. There it is. I put it back. So this is the 1 millimeter. And you can see it's really pretty. It's got a metallic pearl, so it's got a shimmer to it. It's pearlized, so it looks good. Now I'm going to measure out 3 feet, actually 4 feet, excuse me. Doing something different, so let me change that. I'm going to make it into 5 feet, because what we're making, I haven't finished before. So I've got my, I'm just running it through my fingers. This is what, the thread is wildfire, which is super strong. Okay, then I'm going to put one end through my button here. And the button I'm using is a Tierra Cast Starburst. I think of it as the Northern Star or Guiding Light. Guiding Light, that's the soap opera I used to design for. All right, so I still have my ends, and I'm just pulling that all the way to the middle. And I think 5 feet's going to be too much, but by the end of this, you'll know how much to order. So I'm going to leave a little bit of room here, about 3/4 of an inch, and then I'm just going to tie an overhand knot. Keep it to right about, so this has room to sit. Oops, I forgot something. You know what I did? Wow, I'm having a bad brain day. I had a storm come in yesterday and it affected me pretty heavily. But we don't need, I am just off. We don't need 2 threads. We need 1 thread with needles at each end. So let's revamp. Okay, now what I'm going to do here is, before I tighten this, I'm going to go through that hole. Okay, I'm going to bring it down, and I am going to tie overhand knot. in here. And you know what? Using the two needles today, I've decided that my left hand needs more training. So you'll forgive me, but I'm training my left hand and it's a little slower than my right hand, obviously. I am going to be cautious here and just put the tiniest drop of my favorite glue, Loctite Super Glue Gel Control. I'm just going to put just the tiniest dot right on that knot. Okay, that's it. Just for safety reasons. Then I am going to look for my. I'm going to cut this tail off. Now I'm going to tighten my knot right on top of that knot. Okay. I am so messed up today. No, we do. I am okay, guys. I'm so embarrassed. I'm over here just going along, and truth is, we do need both those cords. I mean, both of the threads. So, oh my God, I could have done 1 8-foot long and put it in half. Please forgive me, guys. Oh my God. So I'm opening my knot, and we are indeed going to add that other cord. I am embarrassed. What we should have done, here it is. So we should have measured 8 feet of fire line, found the middle, tied it in the middle in a knot. But since I did two cords, then thought it was one, and now we're going back to two, I'm going to tie this one on as well, right in the same place. So I'm just going to go through that same loop. I am so sorry, guys. I'm switching gears. I was helping design a brain game right before I came here, and apparently my little brain game just had a little brain fart. So there's one. And I'm supposed to be an expert. Uh-huh. Please forgive me. This is why I really want patient customers. Because I make mistakes. But we still do good work. Okay, I've got my glue on there. We're almost where we need to be. Trim the deck off. And then, okay, so we have both our threads, our wildfire, tied on. And I'm going to now tighten over both of them so those knots are not showing. It's pretty handy. You want one basically coming from one side and one from the other. So just tighten that a little more, give it a good tug. And now my setup here is with one of these clamps. I'm going to put my buttonhole through there. And I've got my needle on this side. We're going to thread this one again. And then we will be going. Hopefully, I won't make any more mistakes. So, sorry about that, guys. Both our needles on. So now I'm going to straighten this out and bring it down to this other edge here. I'm going to pull a little bit, but not too tight. And I want a little bit of distance between them because we're going to be filling this space with beads. So I'm just taking my If I had a bigger clamp, I'd be using it, but I've got a small clamp. Just want a little bit of space between them. See, when I make mistakes, then I get nervous. It's funny. But that's what happens with Jill Bill. Whoa. You know what I think I'm going to do? I had a different kind of a... I think it worked on my other board a little while ago, but it's not working on this one. I wonder if a bead stopper would work. No, it does not. Alright. So, i.e., remember to get more clamps. Really, I had this working just fine before. That'll do. Well, there's no space between, but that'll do. Alright, so we've tied our knot. Come back down here. We've tied each of these on. Should have been one. And I'm going to go under one time and then pull it tight. I'm going to go under a second time and pull it tight. Right? I'm going to put this needle here. I'm going to do the same thing on this other side. I'm going under once and then under a second time. All right. Now I'm going to tie an overhand knot. Once and twice. Okay, so now we can start adding beads. Open up some beads here. So these little strands are new and they are on the website. It's like a milky white with a really half coat of AB. Very pretty. Takes two to do this project. Always going to add beads from the right hand side. This is my right hand side. Alright, so I'm picking up two. One, two. I am going to scooch those down. Get them in the middle here. Oh, excuse me, we're starting with one and we're going to taper up. And I guess the mistakes aren't all the way done. So I'm going to put, I'm crossing over and I'm going to my lower left corner. Okay, get this guy up where I want him. And line just like this. It's a little fiddly at first, but it gets to going pretty easily. Okay, now I'm taking my left hand strand and I'm going to go right back through it. Okay, this is where my left hand gets to learn. So holding the bead, and then I'm just going to pull both of those, pop him down, and I'm going to go under again. And then I'm going to go do the same thing here, under again. Alright, then we're going to pull. So we have our first bead. Oh, I didn't go under. Huh. Wow, how did I do that? It is just going to be one of those days. So we had come, we were like this, and then we did this. Alright, so here we are. Finally. I'm making this look much harder than it actually is. Okay, so both our threads are coming from inside, right? So from now on, we're just going to pick up two beads from with the right-hand side, which is going to switch back and forth, all right? So I'm going to pull these down, put my needle down to the bottom left, because you don't want it tangled up with your left-hand needle. I'm going to hold these in place. And then you're going to go back through. But I had this perfectly set up before. Now it seems all fiddly. So I'm going back through. I'm holding those beads together so I know you can't see them. But I'm going through both and I'm keeping my needle on top of the leather, okay? Pull it through. Pull on both of these. And it sets right in. And once again, we're going to go under to be ready for our next bead. I'm going under. Okay. Now, two more beads. So I made that look very troublesome, but really it's just those first couple of beads. Trying to get those in place. Okay, so I'm picking up my other needle and going back through. See that one? See, once you get the first couple in, then it lays much nicer. Again, keep going up from the back to the front. So wrap around that cord. Same on this side. Super easy. Hey, Kim. Truth is that mistakes only bother me when I'm online doing lives because I want to do the best job I can for you. But actually, there aren't only mistakes are just lessons, right? They're just how to fix things. So it's not really a failure at all. It's just a lesson on how to do it. Okay. Get these guys in here. Go back through them. Underneath to the top, wrap around those cords, underneath, top. It's cool. Okay, so we're ready for two more beads. We'll do this a few more times so you can get the lay of the land. Okay, add your beads on the right side, pull them down, leave your needle down here on the left side to keep it out of the way of this other strand. Okay. Hold my beads there and go back through. Okay. And then under to wrap that cord. And then the other strand under and wrap that cord. Now, if you really wanted to, you could go at this point back through and do the same process again, but I find this secure enough for me. So I'm picking up my next two beads. Yes, Lynn, it's a bit of a wobbly mess when you're starting with the first couple. And I like this, using these rondelles. They're just a little different than using seed beads or whatever choice you can. I feel like it's almost like loom work, but not really. Okay, so I'm gonna remember going under around that strand. Under around the second strand. Okay. I'm going to give that a tug. I'm going to keep these tight. Then picking up beads, two beads here. Bringing them down to the leather surface. Putting my needle lower left. Going back through. through teaching my left hand how to do things, and it is wobbly. So, but it's good. I really want both hands to have some talent. And tugging on that, going under and through one strand, and then the second strand. Did I go through? Yep. There we go. And I just like to pinch them like this just to make sure they're all staying in place. Let's do one more. Two more. It is learning. Okay, so I'm taking, put my beads on. I'm putting this needle down to my lower left, picking up my other needle. And going back through. Staying on top of the leather. Going under. Going under. Okay. So basically, you get the gist. This first part's a little tricky, and I made it all very confusing. Through the magic of television, I'm going to move this one out of the way, and I'm going to bring the one that I made previously. So, you need to measure at a certain point, and one way to measure is to take it all off your setup, but you don't have to. You can just take a piece of leather cord from the tip of this down to where your beading ends, and then wrap that around your wrist to see. But since mine is off already, I'm going to go ahead. And I think I need another two rows. So I'm going to set this up again. Here, and down here, get my threads all out of the way here. I think they are crossed. Okay. Then I'm going to put this one thread here is not cooperating. There we go. Let's see, this one worked on here, so let's see if it still works. I don't know how I got it to work the first time, but there's a different kind of... There we go. Alright. So, let's pick up a couple more beads. And I'll show you how to add a clasp. Adding to the right hand side. Oh, wait. Okay, I had come under. Let's see. Yep, I'm on. So that was under. Gonna make sure. And this has to come under for me to be in the right position. Okay. There you go. So you always want to be from coming under in the middle here. Through these two beads. And I'm going to go under. And then I'm going to go under again. And we'll give it a tug. Like that. Add our last two beads. Inside, pick up my other needle, and go back through. Oh, guess what I did, guys? I am so pleased. I booked myself a Hawaii vacation for over 3 weeks. I'm gonna go for Christmas and New Year's. I'm very excited. I have to say that I have never spent money like that. And the night that I booked all my travel and my flight and the condo and all of it, and I got amazing deals because I have friends that are giving me a great price. And I freaked out the whole night. I didn't sleep the whole night going, what am I doing spending money? You know, and I was like, you know what? I deserve it. I'm trying to learn that I deserve it. So what a wonderful way to learn that I deserve it, by treating myself to a Hawaiian vacation. So yay, it will be glorious. I don't do well at Christmas, so I'll pre-record something. We'll figure it out. All right, let's finish this off. Okay, so I haven't gone under yet. I'm going under. I'm going under. Oop, my needle came off, so we don't really need it on at this point. Okay, I just to lay still. Now I'm going to go under again. Remember? Oh, not where under. We got to do one more. We got to taper down. So I do want my needle on. Forgot about that last guy. Oh, for heaven's sakes. Let me flatten it out a little bit. Fire line's a little tough to thread, but you know what? It's so strong. I love it. It keeps your pieces. There we go. Alright. So I'm going to pick up my last bead. Back through on top of the letter, pull it through. Let's make sure everybody's in their spot now. Now we're going to go under once, I'm going to go under twice. I'm going to do the same thing on this other side, going under once. Going under twice. Okay. Then we're going to bring those together and we're going to tie a square knot. Make sure they don't bunch up before you pull real tight. Sometimes that happens. So get it nice and flat before you tie off this guy right here. Here's my second knot. And then I am going to tie a surgeon's knot. Going through once. Going through twice. Okay, and then I'm going to just, once again, I'm just going to little bit of glue to that knot. Boom. And I'm going to release the crack. I'm going to release my bracelet. A little kink there from putting it on the board, but it's okay. So I'm going to make an overhand knot right here. And before I tighten it, we're going to do the same thing that we did. We're going to take both strands, put the ends of both strands here. It's hard to see, I know, that light color thread. I love that tear cast button. I love tear cast. my stuff was supposed to get here this week. I bet you it comes tomorrow, and I'll be super excited to show you all. Okay, so I'm going through the knot. Both loops here and come back through both with both my strands. Okay, old fumbly fingers today. There's one strand, there's two strands, bringing it through. Come on. All right, I'm gonna start again. I got my loop. Fiddly. Okay. I'm just going to grab those and I'm going to tie, pull that down. Tie a knot. And I'm going to tie it again. Through once, through twice. And when you're doing that, you want to pull very slowly so not. Alright, once again, I'm going to add just a tiny bit of glue on that knot. I'm going to cut these strands off. Okay, whoops, I left quite a tail on that one. It's very hard to see. Now, I am going to tighten that knot. Right on top. My knot seems to be having trouble now. I hope I didn't tie. Okay. What did I do? Boy, nothing's coming easy today, guys. What did I do here? Where did this loop come from? Let's figure it out. Oh, it's the loop that it got pulled on and got small. So we just make our loops the same size, then we can do our overhand knot and hide the loop. There we go. Much better. Overhand knot. Got all our beads. It looks so pretty. Okay. And now, so get it on. I gotta make sure. So this is about where you want to size the size of the button and mark it, and then that's where you're gonna tie your second knot. And that loop, that hole, becomes the loop for the button, okay? Now, if you were making this for sale, you could go ahead and measure the width of the button, mark it again, and tie another knot, right? So that way, it's two different sizes. But I don't need two different sizes. And then just slip it through. And it lays nicely. Oops, I got it all crooked, but you get the picture. Very fun project. Okay. Now, I told you with this one, I started by getting one of my opalite glass, and there was, there was 16 inches of cord, and I did the ends, okay, and got it, put it through, and I also took my thread then the same length as the leather, and I put it through. Let's get a length and just show you what I'm talking about. Okay. So I have my leather cord through. Let's pretend this is the length we're going to need. But I don't want to waste fire line. It is not inexpensive. Okay. So I'm going to go ahead, pull this down. Put this through in the same direction as we went with the leather cord. Okay. So it's through. Now we can make both these loops open up and when so this way, if I can get this thread to open up here, this way you don't even have to tie a knot. We're just going to do this, right? We go through. Just go through like this. Pull all your strands through. What did I just do? I came back out of it. I'm on a struggle bus today, gang. All right, let's do this again. I flipped over the top of the... So that. Then you have your strands. And you would start then, make it tight. I actually like to start, yeah, this side's good. So then you would come with both strings and you'd do the same thing, around once, around twice, pull it up, same with the other strand, around once, around twice, pull it up. I'm going to use colored strand from now on. I can, it's hard to see, there's once and twice. There we go. Then, once again, so you want to tie your knot. This is the first knot, and it's not going to show because it's not tied to the leather, alright? So you would start once. Tie it again. Add your glue. And then start the process. You go under, under, bead, back through. Alright? And then, to finish it off, you start the other side the same way. And all I did here was do a barrel knot at the end. So... and used a toggle clasp. So, super simple to do. This is a new clasp we have on the site. So, you could make it either way. And I think that they might look fantastic together. So, if you really wanted to, you could make this very long to have a double strand like this, but that is how you do it. And you can make either or. I had something intelligent to say, but alas, I have lost it. So there are today's projects. Sorry for the struggles. Yeah, well, I was just using this as an example of how to attach, okay? But yes, you totally need, for this, the fire line doesn't need to be as long because you're only doing half at a time. So this was, the leather cord was 18 inches on this, and the fire line was 2.5 feet. And this took two strands of our little beads to make, and this is a 7.5 inch bracelet. So, and I'm pretty sure we didn't need as much leather as I had told you in the beginning. So let's say that this was 3.5 feet long, the leather. Okay, one continuous piece. And then you can have room to tie your double knots. You could use a barrel knot if you wanted to. I just used overhand. And then the thread on this, I would definitely say, I'd still use three arms length because I'm terrified of, I hate adding string. I showed you how to do it last Wednesday, but it's a real pain to have to add. So I always take more than not. But there you go. So a couple of different ways to use the new 1 millimeter. If you wanted, you could go up to the 2 millimeter. I would never wrap the 0.5 millimeter. It's just not strong enough. But I think it's very, very feminine. I like Wildfire or Fireline because of the strength. I'm not a Eslon person, though. I will tell you that I just ordered some crochet hooks. And I did get some Eslon, and I want to make some treasure necklaces, which I love. So that might be what we're doing on Wednesday. I'm also making the Periwinkle Lotus Kit in a russet red. So it'll be the Red Lotus Kit. So we'll have two of those. You're welcome, Lynn. Something's in your hands. The art's in your hands. Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah. The example that I was showing you was just on how to attach your string. I wasn't making the links that I needed. I was just showing you how to attach. That was it. Sorry I was struggling today, but this happens after fires. My lupus kicks in, and what happens is the pain is much greater, and the pain just dulls my brain, honestly. So I'm going to give my brain the rest of the day off, but I cannot tell you how much I appreciate that you came here and stayed even while I was struggling. So thank you for that. I love you all. Be good to yourself. Buy yourself a Hawaiian vacation. Yeehaw. It'll be awesome. Oh, thanks, Maria. You guys are so kind to me. And truly, it really chokes me up because I, as a professional, I've been doing this forever. And before the concussions, I was a whiz. I was really bright and able to make very few mistakes. But now I make them and learn. And I had to learn to read and write and walk and talk and drive, tell time, everything again. And so it was a real humbling experience. So for me, I feel not triumphant, but I'm proud that I'm able to have made my way back and that I have kind people like you that allow me to be where I'm at, which isn't what I used to be. And so I had to grieve the person I used to be and let go of it because it was too hard just going, oh, I wish I was that again. And you know what? You don't want to stay. The only way to get through tough times is to keep going. Keep moving forward. Don't look back. Just keep moving forward. So that's right. That is how we learn. I totally agree, Lynn. That is how we learn. And I've had to learn how to do everything over again. So be glad. I had no idea concussions were so bad, so be careful out there. I wouldn't wish that on my worst enemy. Oh, thank you, Joe. You're so kind. Oh, thank you both. You all are so nice to me. And I'll tell you, kindness to me is, that's my church. It really is. The beauty of nature and my church. Anyways, thank you, Nancy. I don't know if I can give myself grace, but I feel graced by the fact that I'm still able to work. What if I wasn't? I don't know what I would do, really. I'm alone, so Anywho, I love you guys. Thanks for letting me talk about myself a little bit. And thank you for not being impatient with me when I'm learning. We don't have to say mistake, but to say when I'm learning. All right. Well, I hope the rest of your week, your Sunday is wonderful, and that you get off on the right foot tomorrow for Monday, and I'll be back on Wednesday. Be good to yourself and kind to others, and know that I care very much.